allow me, because of time, I'm gonna cut down on the song. Because of time, I'm going to cut down on the song. Ladies and gentlemen, I grew up from Africa, right? And in Africa, sometimes you're eating food and someone comes running crying, "Oh, my child is dead!" What? Someone's child is dead. Immediately, they are thinking of burial preparations and stuff like that. I grew up in a country where you bury people every week. I got tired of burying people. And I said, what goes on? What is going on? Why are children dying before their time? Why are parents burying their children before their time? Before we pray for our friends' children, please, I want you to understand that sin walks with death. If you are a parent, quit living a life of sin, John chapter 8. Revelation 2:20, he says, I will strike your children dead. People are crying in Africa. They are suffering endlessly. But also here in America, maybe they are not burying their children night and day, but their children are going to death, are living in death. Why? Sin is death. The Bible says the wages of sin is death. Please let us wake up. The gospel has been preached, but we are living in continuous sin. Think about your future, your children's children's future, your blessing, and most importantly, heaven. Heaven. Praise the name of Jesus. We silence evil. And we stop evil from monitoring us. We stop evil from monitoring our children. Hallelujah. So, step number three, we are going to pray for our children's friends. The Lord reminded me of the time when I used to be in a boarding school. I went to boarding school at the age of 11, close to 12, in the 90s. And when I went to school, I went as a good girl in an A-shaped skirt, very innocent. All I knew was Jesus. And I come to school and we are mixed people, tribes, languages, color, height in one dormitory. I remember I was taken to Matovu dormitory down in Kako Secondary School in Masaka, Uganda. And when I was taken in Matovu dormitory, there used to be Matovu dormitory. It was long like this with small, different rooms or cubicles. And I was taken there, a young girl. And I began to mix with children that have funny behaviors. But I fell in love with one girl. Not falling in love as in, no. But I liked one girl. She was tall and beautiful. She spoke good English. She had gone to Nakasero Primary School, a high-end school. And I was like, Mama, you know? For her, she's from Nakasero, so she became my friend. Not knowing, she knew all the songs, the worldly songs. Mention but a few. Vanilla Ice, MC Hammer, Whitney Houston, Tony Braxton. She knew all these songs. The girl knew how to dance. She became my friend. I love music and I love dancing. And so I'm telling you, I ganged with her. A girl who used to lead Scripture Union in worship, I ended up running with her to clubs. Ladies and gentlemen, that was the end of my life. Satan took me so deep in hell, so deep in Hades, so deep in the underworld, and my soul was captivated when I was young. Whenever I tried to receive Jesus, I failed. I would repent, but failed. Unfortunately, seeking God, seeking Jesus and miracles, I ended up being captivated by a false Christ. Because there are so many fake churches in Uganda. The wages of sin is death. Whenever you sin, what are you paid? Death. In every area of your life, fear surrounds you. Poverty surrounds you. Rejection surrounds you. Shame surrounds you. You can't even give birth to children. When you give birth to your children, you can lose your children. That's true. I saw my mother bury children. Thank God, by the grace of God, my children are alive. I'm here to tell you that this is grace speaking, and this is love speaking. We are going to pray for our friends' children, our friends' friends, because you realize in my testimony, I joined myself with friends that we are satanic. Muslim and satanic. Instead of preaching Jesus to them, they drew me and took me. Who is taking your child? And where are they taking them? I survived by the grace of God. My pain is beyond human understanding. I can't describe it. I know the pain of life after. But let's pray today that Jesus will save our children. Let's pray today that our children will come to Jesus. Sometimes when we are telling people our testimony, they may think it's for fame. No, it is not for fame. It is for salvation. Grace has come to save you. The mercies of God have come to save you. The Savior's love have come to save you, to save your friend's child, your child's friend. So let's pray. Repeat these words after me. Please do with this every day. Every day, write these points down. Say, Lord, I'm here. You saved me and my children too. But I need you to help my son or my daughter, my son's friends and my daughter's friends, Lord. Father God, I know that they are not walking in the ways of God. Please forgive me. Forgive us in the name of Jesus. I ask you to save our children from satanic powers, Hades, hell, darkness, witchcraft, satanic powers, alcoholism, drug addiction, anything that our children have been doing without our notice. Lies, in the name of Jesus. Father, I'm here praying for my son's friends, for my daughter's friends, in the name of Jesus. Forgive them, Lord. Forgive them, Lord. But save them. Save them. Save them with your love, with your mercy, and with your grace. Father, you did not die for nothing. You shed your blood for us. We ask you to hear our prayer. Father, we pray today that no power, no man, no spirit will hold us in captivity. I pray, Lord Jesus, that our children's children will worship you. I pray for my children's friends in their dormitories. May they receive Jesus as their Lord and Savior. May they stop walking in sin. May they not copy bad habits from TV or phones or conversation. We command Satan, get out of their dormitories. Satan, get out of the neighborhoods. Satan, get out of our homes in the name of Jesus. Father, I pray today that our children who are seeds of light will attract them to bring them to Jesus, to serve you. In the name of Jesus. Father, I can pray over and over again. But I pray today that we learn that we must pray for our children's friends. In the name of Jesus. Protect them by your grace. Seal them in your kingdom. May they not walk in sin. May Satan not touch them ever again. They belong to Jesus. They belong to Christ. And they are sons of the living God. In Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you for being here. I didn't have a microphone, but yeah, all is well in Jesus' name. This is Seeds of Light here in Boston, Massachusetts. Join me every Friday from 9 to 11. We are going to be praying as parents in the name of Jesus. And join me in some of you. I'm going to give you the address every Sunday for our morning service. May God bless you in Jesus' name. I love you. I love you. Remember the scriptures we looked at. John chapter 8. Psalm 103. Revelation 2:20. Amen. And John 14. Let us use those scriptures. Please don't just watch these videos. Read scripture. Study with your child. The word of God is a double-edged sword. Whenever you're reading the word, the enemy was trying to take your child. He'll see that sword and he'll flee. Amen. We praise you, Jesus, and we love you in Jesus' name. Amen. Enjoy this song. So I want to announce something. So here at Seeds of Light Boston, me and my son Tyrus, he has an art gallery. And please support my son as God has fought our battles. Amen. We make these wonderful photo frames. I think you can see what that says. A life-saving golden word, Galatians 5. This is the scripture that God used when he was saving my life. Amen. After I had gone to Celebration International Church, I gave my testimony. And the Lord began to speak to me. So please support us. A gift of $20 or more, we can send you this this wonderful photo frame that has been designed by me and my son, and this wonderful art picture that my son drew. As you can see, Jesus is washing the feet of the disciples. I encourage you to buy this. A gift of $40 or more, you can get this. Please call my number if you want to support us at 978-991-7034. Remember, no one is greater than Jesus and Father God. I love you. May God bless you. And to God be the glory. Amen. To the end, you will be free. Your
now. All to Jesus now. I'm holding nothing back. Holding nothing back.
Come and sing. Surrender your child, surrender your heart, surrender your soul, surrender to the Lord, to the King, to the Lord, all powerful. Surrender all, surrender your children, surrender your daughter, surrender. Thank you very much for being here at Seeds of Light Boston. I'm Mama Rachel Gayla Kisa. Hallelujah. And my number is 978-991-7034. Just in case you want me to come and speak in your church, please call that number. Or go to www.rachelgaylaministries.org. Also support Saviour's Love Uganda, Missions Uganda, that is led by my son, Tara Stendo. If you are in the areas of Kampala, Uganda, every Saturday, Kagoma, 12 to 3, we meet. Run and see a change in your child's life. I love you.